We just finished drawing some graphs of matrix. They actually a couple, so I just showed you this one that's highlighted. You can do the rest on your own. I'll make the file available on the description. And what I want to do in this video, I want to find the mode. I want to use something called the measures of central tendency to describe the data. Measures of central tendency are like this: the mode, median, mean. Yeah, they describe typical values in the data set. And since our points don't have so much variation, I think here mean would be really good. But it's also good practice to do the other ones. So I got this formula from tutorialspoint.com for mode. You just have to copy paste it in really quick. Okay, it's in. Now we are now swapping the data to data table so that we can do more analysis with it. I initially, when I was learning data table, I found it a bit harder, but when you get used to it, it's a very good way of dealing with large data sets. And this one is pretty small, but yeah, it's a really good way of analyzing data using R, this package by M. Dowley, according to the citation I gave in the previous video. So we've converted it, and right now our data frame is a data table. So if you look at it, so this class confirms that, so it's successfully converted into our data into a data table. Now here is the trick about data table. So this is basically how data table looks like. This is how the commands are given. So this one in simple terms is, it'll find in each column, it'll find the mode, median, mean, variance, and standard deviation. So let's just do the ones that we're interested in for now. Then it gives you, and even if you can confirm with what you did last time here, the mean for all is 4.9, and you see it's 4.9. So it's basically we've like replicated that formula, and we're now using it. Now the last one is this, which I'm mostly interested in, because I was mostly interested in variability. Yeah. So all that's left is interpretation, but our data is really small. The 10 data points is not so good, but if you get like the greater than or equal to 30, that's when it's easier to use the statistical inference techniques. And thanks for following along. And I'm looking forward to seeing your graphs and your analysis. Thank you for watching.